Hi everyone, we are back at YNS in Minutes with me, Rahmat Ramdhani, a consultant from Yamada Consulting and Spire Indonesia. In this episode, we will discuss about the transformation of genomic technology in cancer treatment in Indonesia. Cancer is one of the major health problems in Indonesia and is the second highest cause of death after cardiovascular disease. The Global Burden of Cancer Study, or GLOBACAN, by World Health Organization has shown the total number of cancer cases in Indonesia in 2020 reached 396,914 cases, and total deaths reached 234,511 deaths. Breast cancer has the largest share of cancer cases in Indonesia with 65,858 cases or 16.6% of all cancer cases. Cervical cancer forms the second largest number of cancer cases in Indonesia with 36,633 cases or 9.2% of all total cases. Lung cancer is at third place with 34,783 cases or 8.8% of cases. Liver cancer at fourth place with 21,392 cases or 5.4% of all cases. And nasopharyngeal cancer is the area above the back of the throat with 19,943 cases or 5% of total cases. Some of the challenges are the following. First, unequal facilities for cancer patients in Indonesia. According to a data from the Social Security Administrator for Health or BPJS Kesehatan, out of all hospitals in Indonesia, there are only 714 hospitals with chemotherapy facilities, 507 hospitals with an oncology team, and 35 hospitals with radiotherapy facilities. Second, the low number of oncology specialists. The Ministry of Health notes that there are only 139 doctors specializing in internal disease and hematology and oncology consultant in Indonesia, spread around 17 provinces. Meanwhile, there are only 217 doctors specializing in surgical oncology, spread around 28 provinces. There are 118 doctors who specialize in radiation oncology and even fewer specialists in hematology and child oncology with 80 doctors. And third, low awareness of cancer screening for early detection. 70% of cancer patients in Indonesia only began their medicine when the cancer has already entered its late stage. Between 2007 and 2018, the total number of cancer patients aged 30 to 50 who underwent screening was 3,664,625, which was 9.8% of the target. In cancer prevention efforts, the awareness of early detection of cancer is important to increase the probability of recovery. Technological advance in the health sector led to genomic testing, which is used to check genomes in one cancer cell in order to study changes in genes or proteins in cells that are different from normal cells. For people suffering from cancer, genomic testing on cancerous cells often can give important information, such as the cancer cell's growth rate, as well as whether certain medications such as therapy or immunotherapy medicines might help in curing their cancer. Testing is usually done on a sample tumor from biopsy or operation if possible, but may also be done using blood or saliva samples or samples of other body fluids. One of the technologies used in the field of molecular biology and genomic science is known as next generation sequencing, or NGS. NGS can be used to analyze changes in the DNA which is related to health problems. Moreover, this technology can identify genetic mutation related to genetic disease and assist in diagnosing variants that cause disease due to genetic disorders. Today, several clinic laboratories in Indonesia provide genomic testing services utilizing the next generation sequencing technology. such as Prodia, Diagnos, Calgen InnoLab, Laboratorium Klinik Genica, and Tanya DNA by JSE Lab. Prodia has several products and services available in the early detection of cancer. One of them is called Prodia Wellness Genomic. The service provides information such as genomic profile and prediction of the risk 39 diseases including cancer and its variants. Next, Diagnos has a product which provides genetic testing for the health of the reproductive system, fetus in pregnant women, oncology checkup, and others. One of their products is called DNA HOF, which provides information on the risk of a fetus being born with genetic disorders. Lastly, Calgen InnoLab has a product called SpotMass, which is a screening test of a 5 different types of cancer such as lung, liver, breast, gastric, and colon cancer using NGS to detect ctDNA. Aside from that, they also have a product called NutriGenome Life, which analyzes variation of DNA related to certain lifestyles using saliva samples to study the link between genetic factors and the nutrition with genetic expression in the body. Nowadays, those products are marketed by influencers, which creates a significant impact in the healthcare industry in Indonesia. This has been done by Prodia, Diagnos, and Calgen InnoLab, who promote their health products specially for cancer risk detection, as well as human genetic profile through endorsement and testimonies given on social media such as TikTok, Instagram, and YouTube. Aside from that, the Indonesian government through the Ministry of Health or Kemenkes has officially launched the Biomedical Genome Science Initiative or BGSI. BGSI is an initiative to collect genetic information genomes from humans and pathogens such as virus or bacteria, or more commonly known as whole genome sequencing or WGS. Through BGSI, the WGS methods will be used in the research in developing cancer medication. The Ministry of Health has supplied 40 egg machines which will be distributed to several nation hospitals participating in the BGSI. Those machines are equipped with high-capacity sequencing technology which are able to process human genome samples. The early detection of cancer is very important to increase the probability of recovery. The increase in awareness of the importance of early cancer detection through the use of genomic technology is hoped to reduce the risk of death caused by cancer in Indonesia. The healthcare industry in Indonesia also has the potential to be optimistic, since the demand for health service is also growing. Aside from that, advance in science and technology can drive the Indonesia healthcare industry to improve. That is all for this episode of YNS in Minutes. Thank you for watching and see you in the next episode.